Hey guys, welcome back. We are in Angie's mom's closet right now because we are recording my very first podcast, and it will be about music. And I have Angie with me because I consider her professional in music. Just because she had a music appreciation class in school. She took it, she passed it somehow. So you want to say what you want. So we will talk about music. And I will ask her those questions probably you're curious about. First of all, what are people listening to in America? And by people, I mean young people, like people our age. And by America, I mean the area we are in, like southern Texas.
Oh, okay. Well, in America, it's really diverse, so I can't really speak that everybody listens to one sort of thing. I mean, you have people that like rock, and like other people that like more reggae music and hip-hop, rap, pop, whatever, right? But what is usually heard here around southern Texas, especially the area where we live in, is a lot of, I don't want to be very, it's very, like, reggae, definitely, a lot of reggae, like hip-hop type of stuff, rap, also here, and what in Mexico we call corridos. That's what a lot of people listen to these days. You go to a party and you have like a mix of some good rap bops and hip-hop, and then you have like this like smooth silky reggae style of music.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, that's a lot of what people around here listen to, and it's very, you can be, and then of course there's like people who still listen to like country. I mean, mm-hmm. They're honestly not gonna lie, a lot of those songs are actually pretty good. Like, I don't know why people make fun of country, but like, I don't know. Yeah.
Okay, so you said rap.
Yes.
What kind of rap? Like old school rap or the more modern
rap? Modern. Yeah, definitely okay. Modern rap. There is like a lot of songs. Like, now what people are doing is that they're listening to, I know this is gonna sound like so like ugh cringy and like, alright, but I mean, it is true. The app TikTok is influencing a lot of songs and rap. Of course, you have, like, your mainstream rappers, which are, like Drake and, like, Travis Scott, Post Malone, who are, like, you know, they're really good rappers, and everybody, you know, you still listen to their music, and there are new albums and singles and stuff like that, but people are starting to listen to a lot of, like, more smaller rappers who are, like, less known, but, like, that one song that did like give them like their big break.
Mm-hmm. So like what would you say, which is like the most trending rap song right now?
Trending rap song, oh my god. I personally, I can't say, because I mean, but in my opinion it would be
just pick a song.
Lottery by K-Camp.
Lottery
by K Camp.
Wait. Renegade. Let's go. Cash on me. I got hit the lottery. The lottery. Hoes a trip. Watch on how they follow me. Wait.
Okay. And you mentioned that there is this reggaeton.
Yes.
Which, how would you define reggaeton? Because it's kind of a hard topic to talk about, honestly.
Yeah, it really is. It really is.
But first of all, it's usually in Portuguese or in Spanish, mm-hmm. like, not in English.
Yeah.
It's like more a Latino thing.
Acércate, acércate un poco más, que así de lejos no logramos nada. Si te pegas puedes ayudar a que yo te recuerde.
Estoy enamorado de cuatro, baby. Siempre me dan lo que quiero. Chiquen cuando yo les digo. Ninguna me pone, pero yo soy casado.
hay una soltera. La otra medio psycho y si no la llamo se desespera.
Yeah, it's more a Latino thing, and what really, like, sometimes, like, the what people use as in the industry is, like, they get mainstream rappers, like, for example, Drake and, like, Jason Derulo, and they mix it up with more, like, popular reggaeton artists, which are, like, for example, J Balvin, Maluma, Prince Royce, Daddy Yankee, like, people like that, and, like, of course, they make their own remix of, like, a song that was maybe already made, or they actually create a new song, and that's what really gets, you know, like, American listeners who, like, listen to, like, for example, like, those mainstream rappers or mainstream artists from America to listen to more reggae music and Latino music. But yeah.
Yeah, I can't get enough of your love. Give me some more of it. I can't get enough. Yeah. Cause I can't get enough.
Dice que no le es suficiente. Está mal de la mente.
Andamos activos, perico, pim, pim. Billetes de 100 en el maletín. Que retumbe el bajo, Bobby Valentín. Yeah. Aquí prohibido mal, dile Charitín. Que perpico le tengo claritín. Yo llego a la disco y se forma el motín.
Diamond District in the chat.
Bad Bunny, bad, 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 bad.
Certified, you know I'm
gang. Atrás se puede más.
Pero hice todo este llanto por nada. Ahora soy una chica mala. And now you kicking and screaming a big toddler. Don't try to get your friends to come holla.
I see, so the thing is, nowadays with this really fast industry, music industry, yes, is that songs changes.
Mm-hmm.
Like, they come and they go.
Yes, exactly.
So, and I don't think that it's different in any genre. I think it's like, yeah, a whole...
Yeah.
So, what do you think in America, in our area, how much time does it take for a song to quote-unquote die? So, like, lose its popularity, fade?
Well, of course, like, right after the release, first of all, you make a huge hype about releasing songs. So, like, after that, everyone's, like, literally attacking and listening to the song, like, on repeat so many times. But honestly, once, like, after, I would guess, like, I would give it, like, 1.5 to 2 weeks for a song to, quote-unquote, yeah, die. Because, and of course, after those 2 weeks, people are still listening it, but, like, you can't really say, like, oh my god, have you listened to this and this and that by this and this person?
Mm-hmm.
Because people are like, oh yeah, I already did, like, and then, like, you, radio stations make it of, like, they put it on repeat so many times on their, like, playlists or on their tracks, so you kind of get used to, like, hearing that song, and then after a while, you're just like, okay.
Because, like, for example, what, for one time, I was younger, I was, I think, in 7th grade, and I was listening to a song called Firestones, or Fireworks, or something with fire, and one of my classmates came to me and saw that I was listening to that song, and she was like, that's so old, and the song came out last year.
Yeah.
I was like, it's not old. Like, have you listened to AC/DC? It's that old for what? So, and she told me that it's cringe.
Yeah, like, it's cringy, yeah.
It's cringy to listen to. Yeah,
because you listen to it, like, for example, a song that has been released a year ago, and you listen to it, and you're like, oh my god, like, you act like if it was 20 years ago, like, oh my god, it was such good moments, or, like, because the popularity and the trend that it really brought up, like, in social media, and radio stations, and literally, like, around your friends, also, you hear it, and, like, you remember, like, all this, like, oh my god, I remember when it came out, and it was, like, super popular, and, like, especially a lot of rap songs, that's what happens to them. That they do release it, and, like, for a while, they're like, wow, like, this is a really good song. And, like, yeah, after, like, a month, yeah, like, even, like, the shortest time of a month, like, and goes on to a year, you're like, wow, it's such an old song. And, like, you pretend like they released it, like, in, what, right now we're in 2017.
Mm-hmm.
And you check the actual date that it released, like, their album or their single, and it was, like, 2019, 2018, and I'm like, wow, like, that was not long ago.
What do you think, how do people around here, relate to old music? And by old, I'm meaning, like, 30 years ago, like, in the 70s or in the 80s, or even the 60s, like, the Beatles, and, you know, those legends, like, the Queen, I mentioned AC/DC, like, not just rock bands, but, like, the old kind of music. How do younger generations here connect to that?
Well, we find, like, after, we don't really, like, look at the lyrics anymore. And especially, like, now that, like, we're getting more into modern times, you literally listen to the lyrics and it could be, like, the worst message ever, but, like, the beat is good, so, like, I'm going for it. I'm going to listen to it. I like it. And with 90s music and, like, 80s, 70s, like, music like that, even, like, rappers, like, popular rappers still made it a point to, like, create a powerful message or, like, a good message. Or, you know what, it might just be one of those songs that you're, like, okay, I'm just gonna, like, listen to and vibe to and stuff like that. But I feel like teenagers now, when they listen to those songs, it's, like, they wanna, like, feel like a throwback. Because, like, now, like, the vintage style is really in times. And, like, it is true, like, when you're, like, history repeats itself. Mm-hmm. It is true. We are going back to those, like, girls just wanna have fun. Those type of songs. Like, yeah. Okay. Sorry for my cringy singing, people. But, like those songs. And, like, media is actually really a good influencing. Because, like, a lot of artists that are, like, super popular and super modern still listen to those songs. And, like, I have seen on Instagram, like, when people post, like, picture or, like, they post a song and it is, like, from the 80s or from the 90s, and it's usually, mm-hmm. that's what inspired, like, now what we call, like, our super huge pop stars, like Ariana Grande, Shawn Mendes, all mm-hmm. these people.
So it's cringe to listen to a song from a year ago, but it's not cringe to listen to something 30 years ago.
Yeah
okay.
Like, if you mm-hmm. listen to it, you're, like, considered, like, wow, that's so vintage, like, wow, you're so cool. And I'm like, uh-huh. okay, that's okay.
I see. So another question, which I think it really differs from country to country. How do people listen to music?
Well, here in the US, Texas, where we live, right? It's more like now on a mobile device.
Mm-hmm.
You either have, like, apps like Spotify, Pandora, Apple Music, SoundCloud, all these things, right? All these apps. But I feel like what really, the apps that are more used here is Apple Music and Spotify.
Mm-hmm.
You get business is business. Spotify gives you, like, you have to pay for a membership and stuff like that, and you get to listen to, like, every single, like, streamer and artist. Like, for example, Drake, I don't know if he still does this but he used to do where he wouldn't not, you know how every artist posts a music video,
mm-hmm.
and, like, you get your song, like, it's the release the day of. Well, what he used to do, Drake, is that he wouldn't release a music video, and he wouldn't, like, release a free version of the song where you can, when it's released, you can hear it. Like, no, you, like, forcefully had to do something that it gave him gaining.
Mm-hmm.
And I mean, it's not bad, it's just, that's how it is. That's just the business industry. Like, it's nothing really that people can be like, oh my god, why do you do that? Like, that's so rude.
Yeah.
But it's just artists trying to get money. But yeah, usually it's, like, now, like, you pay for Spotify memberships and stuff like that, and, like, really, like, people don't really, like, look at YouTube videos anymore. Like, YouTube, mm-hmm. like, music videos and, like, the audio just on YouTube. Like, they have, like, their music streaming service on their mobile device.
I see. And what about TikTok? I will be honest. TikTok in Romania, in Transylvania, is something 10 to, I would say, 13. Like, that's the age yeah. range people yeah. do it, and probably, like, younger than 10, but, like, mm-hmm. my sister, she's 10, and she uses TikTok, and
yeah.
when I came here, and the first thing I got, like, the first question I got was, like, do you have TikTok?
Yeah.
I was like, I don't, but I can give you my sister's TikTok if you want to follow someone.
Yeah, yeah.
So, what do you think about it, and how does it impact music?
It's honestly, like, we all, after it got purchased by another person, that app musically was, like, it was the 2015, that was, like, the year of Musically, right? And then it got purchased by someone else, the app became TikTok, and a lot of people were just like, oh my god, like, if Musically was super bad, like, I'm, like, imagine how cringy it is gonna be now. And then, like, everybody just, like, mostly if you ask anyone, you're like, how did you, like, come along to, like, download TikTok again, like, remember?
Yeah, 'cause,
like,
yeah.
Yeah, when I was, like, 10, 11, I was Musically, like, wow, like, I was obsessed. I will do, like, 15 videos a day, actually post them. And, like, yeah, my you know, sister does the get, same like, thing. My few likes, right? And now I was like, oh, my God, like, everybody is downloading TikTok. Like, let's just see what it's about. And everybody just download, like, everybody, if you ask, I downloaded it as a joke. And, like, now people are, like, oh, wow. Like, they're actually, like, hardcore into it. I can't say addicted, but, like, something like that, yeah. And now with, like, a lot of music that people hear these days, or, like, rap music especially, is TikTok videos and like 15 second parts of a song that they find catchy, and they're like, oh my God, like, oh my God, I really like it, let me search it online, or let me search it on Spotify, or this and that. Mm-hmm. And that's how they get more streamers and stuff like that. But yeah, TikTok, honestly, for me, in my opinion, is a really big influence on music. Really, really big. Because usually they put a song and like they don't know, like, they don't know it, they can't know it at all, but like those 15 seconds that were on that TikTok video come along and they're like, oh my God, I know this song, I love this song, what the heck, give me the name. Mm-hmm. And so honestly, TikTok really has impacted music today, and I feel like impacted a, like, media in general.
Mm-hmm. So do people still listen to radio here?
Yes, totally. Although, like, times are changing and we are, like, moving and literally everything into our own mobile device and phones, people still listen to the radio. And there's, like, now there's more diversity. Now, for example, streaming service Pandora, that usually just, like, started out as a streaming service for your phone, now has a radio channel.
Mm-hmm.
So, like, we still listen to the radio, and, like, we still... But, like, what radios do now is just, like, they kind of just create more mixes, like, a DJ type of thing. Instead of, like, putting... Of course, they still put, like, the actual songs of, like, the artists. But what they do is, like, more, like, do, like, DJ mixes and, like, remixes of everything. And it just makes merge every mm-hmm. song, popular song, into one. And they put that on repeat. And that's also what I feel, like, influences a lot of, like, what people listen to. And, like, the artists that get known, like, they just put the new songs on repeat. And I'm just like, oh, my God, I like that song. Let me search it. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, radio is still, like, we might not, like, feel it, but, like, no, like, I always listen, I always connect my phone to my car, or I always have my Bluetooth on, but radio does impact a lot, and is still impacting music to this day. Still going strong.
Mm-hmm. Okay, now, we focused really on the younger generation. What about our parents? The grown-ups, like, the wise people.
Yes.
What are they listening to in their area? Because I'm pretty sure they don't listen to Hungarian metal.
Yeah, honestly, I get surprised every time, like, I can be listening to music, for example, my mom and dad. My mom and dad are very different people. My dad is very, like, old school, like, he's like, no, like, in his opinion, like, I mean, I have to respect his opinion. I don't think that way. That's not my opinion, but everybody respects everyone's opinion.
Mm-hmm.
He personally thinks that, like, you know, music back then was, like, had more of a message. It was more meaningful, and it was mm-hmm. more, like, just something to enjoy, too. And they weren't just, like, getting a new song out of the box, like, every single day and, like, you know, just to make money out of it. Like, they actually enjoyed the craft that is music. And he likes more, like, classical pieces and jazz and something more calm and, like, cool. My mom, on the other hand, she has modernized with times. Like, for example, she will get bored to death with one of my dad's songs. Yeah, they're nice to enjoy and everything. But my mom is a hardcore, like, she is a teenager. She loves listening to, like, modern pop, and you put her a good rap song, and if she feels it, she'll start dancing, like, you know, tiny little dances in the car, but...
What song would she like?
11 p.m. by Maluma.
Oh,
that is a very good song. God, very good song.
11 de la noche todavía no contesta. 1 de la mañana todavía no hay respuesta. 2 de la mañana me dice que está dispuesta. 3 de la mañana yo te tengo una propuesta. ¿Cómo hacerte entender que conmigo tú te ves mejor, que en mi carro tú te ves mejor?
My opinion, yes.
So, like, our sister Leslie, she loves reggaeton. We always listen to reggaeton in the car because she's driving and the driver picks the songs.
Yeah. But the sister has the Spotify streaming service, so
yeah.
I have to put the songs. But yeah, I mean, honestly, when I was little, I was just like full, like solely based on pop and stuff like that. Like only pop, only Shawn Mendes, only Ariana Grande, Sabrina Carpenter, all that good stuff, right?
Oh yeah, you're a huge
yeah,
Sabrina
I'm a
Carpenter.
Super huge fan of Sabrina Carpenter. Got to meet her last year. It was a whole other experience, but that's for another day. But yeah, like I was solely based, but like now that I'm like, as I'm growing up, I understand like, oh my God, like rap, okay. Like sometimes I might not like what it says, or like it might be too like brutal, like the, not the message, but like
mm-hmm.
just the lyrics in general. But like, you're just like, it gets you hyped and pumped up that you don't really care about what they say anymore. You're just like, oh yeah, I love the beat. And honestly, everything is solely based on the beat. Now rappers are starting to like make like these more meaningful songs that they still have their like nice beat to it, and like the rap the soul, the basic structure of a rap song, but they do put more like meaningful messages. Like for example, this rap artist called Logic and NF, they're very more calm artists that do release like very like for people and their feelings, and like when you're on like you're feeling down or like you're just feeling misunderstood, you can listen to your songs and they'll be like, okay.
I've been on a low, I've been taking my time. I feel like I'm out of my mind. I feel like my life ain't mine. Who can relate? Woo! I've been on a low, I've been taking my time. I feel like I'm out of my mind. I feel like my life ain't mine. I don't wanna be alive.
Okay, we already mentioned a lot of stuff that influences music around here.
Yes.
From TikTok to radio, but I wanted to ask you this because it was a really strange scenario last year where I live in Hungary mostly. We have this talent show. I'm sure you heard about it because I think it comes from America. X Factor?
Oh, yeah, the X Factor. Yeah,
yes.
Yeah, yeah.
So we had that. And actually, a rap group, two guys from my city, who were Hungarians, they went to the Hungarian
X Factor,
yes, which was in Hungary. So they kind of left the country and went there. And they started out as a, like, kind of like old school rappers,
yeah,
and then shifted to a more modern style, and suddenly because of the show everybody started to listen to their music,
yeah,
and everybody started to appreciate it. And my question is, TV and talent shows like this, do they influence the music taste here, or they are kind of out of fashion?
Well, since shows like that, like The X Factor, are just solely just, you know, like the TV channel, like if you miss it, like it's gone, you're done, right?
Yeah.
Of course, you can look back on it on YouTube, but you can't look for like a certain person and stuff like that. But like that, I say that they didn't influence and that they're not influencing would be a lie. For example, big groups like Fifth Harmony, they came out of there. Shawn Mendes also. I don't remember more of them, but I do remember like a lot of our big artists today did audition. Like, you see their auditions for the X Factor and
like
America's...
Like, One Direction.
Yeah, One Direction.
Yeah.
American Idol. Like, shows like that. So, back then, they definitely did, like, bring more listeners to the group or to the artist. Right now, I can't really, like, confirm that no, they do, or yes, they, like, you know?
Mm-hmm.
But they did. They did have, like, years ago, they did really have an impact. But right now, what I can say is that, of course, there's not as many people, like, watching it as there was back then, but that there is still some viewers, and that still, like, every little thing that you get to as publicity will definitely help you.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So, like, in TV, like, Disney Channel is, I think, another big factor in the music industry, right? Because, for example, your forever favorite, Sabrina Carpenter, she's basically from
Disney. Yeah, and we have, like, Selena Gomez, Demi Lovato, Miley Cyrus. Disney does have a reputation of, yeah, being one of the happiest places on Earth, right? But, like, most of our artists broke free from their little, like, bubbly Disney stage. But, I mean, a lot of, of course, fans are going to be like, oh my god, I'm so proud of you, like, you got out of, like, that situation, and, like, they call it situation because, you know, contracts and, like, bad deals with stuff, like, they're a serious thing, and, like, artists, I feel like, could be bigger, but, mm-hmm. like, the company just kind of brought them down, like, no, you're like, you're ours, like, your songs are mm-hmm. our companies, right? So, for example, Selena Gomez, like, she could have had way more publicity, like, at a younger age, if she had, like, done, like, she had recorded music with another managing industry. For example, mm-hmm. Hollywood Records is something, like, that is controlled partly by Disney.
Mm-hmm.
So, artists, like, even though they're not in their Disney shows anymore, in their Disney days, how they call it,
mm-hmm.
they, I mean, they're still under the contract, right? So, they still have to make their music.
Mm-hmm.
And, like, for example, Sabrina Carpenter, too, like, she... media said, like, they have, she could have been more popular. Like, of course, mm-hmm. you have people, that hear, or they, when they hear her name, you're like, oh my god, yeah, I know her. But, like, usually when they do it, they're like, oh my god, yeah, isn't she, like, from that Disney show, Girl Meets World, or, like, this, yeah. I don't remember the show, but I've seen her around, like, from Disney.
Yeah, yeah.
And they always mention Disney. That, of course, Disney did help them really get a platform to build. And then, of course, they went off on their own. They decided to, you know, like, just take their own road, right? But, for example, yeah, Sabrina Carpenter, people feel like she could have been way more famous if she had, like, done, like, signed up with the right mm-hmm. managing company instead of Hollywood Records and stuff like that.
Or I think, like, she's not from Disney, but, like, a really success story is Ariana Grande.
Yeah.
She's from Nickelodeon. I don't mm-hmm. think that Nickelodeon affected her... No. Her musical contracts, but she definitely had fame, yeah. Yes, an image before too. She started.
Yeah,
and then she completely changed that image.
Mm-hmm.
But
and like the good thing for her is that people accepted that new image that she wanted to build. And,
yeah.
Most of the time, fans are very supportive, but like most of the time,
yeah, there are like memes about her like being extremely white mm-hmm. in the beginning of the. 2010s.
The decade,
yes. At the beginning of the decade, and now she's just...
Super tan,
like, almost Hispanic.
Yeah.
And you go back and watch Victorious, and you're like, this girl is white as...
Yeah.
And, okay, another genre, which I would say that at home definitely is in spotlight right now, is K-pop.
You
can hate it, or you can love it, or you just don't care about it, mm-hmm. but do people listen to K-pop here?
Oh, totally, definitely. The Asian culture is, there's no place, I think, in my opinion, there's no place where at least one person doesn't listen to it, or at least one person doesn't like it, or wants to hear it, you know?
Mm-hmm.
I do have a friend that is... I have, like, two friends that are super obsessed with K-pop groups, like BTS.
Yeah,
and, And, yeah, like, BTS is one of, like, you know, the most common, the biggest group of K-pop, right, that
yeah,
people know.
Yeah, my best friend went to London to listen yeah. to BTS,
yeah,
like,
yeah,
in
yeah.
real life. So,
definitely. Yeah. And people do listen to it, and, like, of course you have your die-hard fans that, like, know everything about every K-pop group,
yes.
all the rules. And, like, when one of my friends was actually, like, I was interested, I was like, okay, like, how does that K-pop thing work?
Because
mm-hmm. a lot of people are, like, they're very, like, judgmental, like, oh my god, everybody looks the same.
Yeah.
You see that.
Oh.
And, like, or every song is the same, like, every song, how can you tell, like, or they're like, oh my god, they're Korean, or, like, they're from here, they're from there, how can you understand what they're saying? Like, that's
yeah.
just trash, right? And, but... that's, like, of course, their opinion, right? And then you have the people I personally, like, I'm not super interested, like, diehard that I could, like, become, like, a super, like, awesome, like, oh my god, I love every K-pop group and this
mm-hmm.
certain group and BTS and blah, blah, blah. But I'm super interested because, like, with that Korean, like, K-pop, how can I say, like, genre,
mm-hmm.
it's a whole different story, like, from managing companies to the actual songs to the actual group to like the image that they have to do, it could be super, like, it's so different from, like, for example, an American band, Jonas Brothers,
yeah.
to like BTS, like the rules that they both have to follow. I mean, they're both huge groups, but the things that they the images and the things that they have to do to keep that is insane. Yeah, insanely different. And, like, my friend gladly explain that this group and this and that and what to do. Like, they start since, like, the age of 10.
Yeah, and they are preparing them. Yeah, they're preparing them. And schools and how, like, voice practices. Exactly.
And, like, the looks, too. Like, you mean, of course, right now we're, like, thank God that people are more standing up about not just the looks and, like, personality and, like, talents and hobbies and all that good stuff. But, of course, there's still going to be the people who go off based on looks. And looks do kind of still, sadly, have something to do.
Yeah, that thing that you cannot say who is who because they are really similar. Yeah. Right before I left, that friend I already mentioned who went to London to listen to BDS in real life, she said that, okay, you have to learn how to differ them before you go.
Yeah.
And we were sitting on the couch and she was pointing at their faces and I just tried to say their names and I couldn't.
Got them all wrong, yeah.
Yes, but what I heard is that Asian people think the same of us.
Of Americans.
That of white people, that they cannot tell the difference. So...
What the...
I mean, I think Leslie told me that she had a friend who... from during exchange from Japan who said that, look, you all look the same.
Wow, really?
Yeah, which I don't understand. But we don't understand how can they be that similar. So
yeah.
Anyways, my next question is that who would you call right now in this very moment the most popular artist in Southern America / North Mexico?
Like, Latin America, stuff like that?
Yeah, like, including all the genres, what do you think is the, like, the most popular one? And who's the most popular singer, or performer, or artist?
I mean, my opinion, I would have to say it's an old one, but a good one. Either Beyonce or Taylor Swift.
Mm-hmm.
They of course you still have them from like the good old country days, or like when Beyonce was like lesser known and she did not have like this huge platform that she has today. And, like when you hear your name, we're like, oh no, all these new rappers and stuff like that. But like mostly they all come for a good like year or two and then they fade, or they're just like they don't have that much fame. Of course, they start, like, fizzling out, right? Beyonce and Taylor Swift has been, like, one of those people. They can go on a two-year break. Like, Selena Gomez, she just went on a two-year break. She came back, and everyone, like, got so, like, oh, my God, happy. Like, oh, my God, my childhood. Like, she's back. She's going to release a new album, this and that, singles, whatever. And you're just like, wow, like, they just never fizzle out. So, for me, I'm going off based on, like, not popular because drama also, like, always makes people more publicity. And bad or good, publicity is publicity. And gets your name around, that's what your name's going to be, right? But Beyonce and Taylor Swift, when Taylor Swift made her Reputation album, she was like, oh my God, like, did you hear this? She's throwing shots at this person. But she came back and, like, everyone was so happy and excited to hear her new music and her new chapter, her musical chapter. So, honestly,
her new song, it came out, like, few months ago. You need to calm down.
Oh yeah. You need to calm down. You're being too loud. And I'm just like,
you need to just stop. Like, can you just not skip on my gown? You need to calm down. That one, it has like
you
a really
to calm down. Yeah.
Yeah, that has like a really, really, really strong message.
Yeah. And you go from like this like bad girl, like I'm done with everyone, like I'm like this is like, on my own, I'm done getting pushed around and like getting this fake things, like fake publicity like told about me and all this stuff. And then you from that Reputation like badass album, you go to Lover. Which is her more, like, just, like, more carefree, more...
Yeah,
she goes back to her bubbly. Yeah. And from the songs to her album cover, you just see a whole two different Taylor Swift right there.
Yeah.
And, I mean, it's good. They all have their little musical chapters, and, like, there's a staple in everything, right? But, honestly, you can go back to her, like, first album, and you will have, like, the bops that everybody knows, like, the, like, 22, like, I'm feeling 22. Yeah, yeah. People still play, like, they'll turn, like, 22, and they'll play this song just, like, as a little, like, memory, right? And you can go back to her first album or to her Reason album, and there will always be, like, that one song that everybody knows.
I see.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, this will be then the last question, because, okay, we are girls here, so obviously we cannot represent the guys' opinion.
Yeah.
But I know that in my city, not just for guys, but I think guys are not that into pop, they are more into techno.
Oh, yeah.
And I don't know what's up with that here, because I know that, like, especially in Romania, especially in my city, minimal techno is, like, a really popular thing to listen to, and I don't have a problem with it. I can enjoy it for a certain amount of time, which is more than 5 minutes, and so I wanted to ask you, what about techno, because I don't really hear it around.
Yeah,
it.
Like, right here it's, like, no, not really that popular as reggae, rap, pop. Like, those three genres are, like, right now, like, the top.
I see.
But you still, of course, there's not, I can't say that there's not one single person that does not listen to it, you know, they're still at the clubs, they might, of course, they put, like, your jams, and, like, oh my god, I love this song, I hear it all the time, I have it on my Spotify playlist, whatever. But they'll usually just, like, play those songs, and they'll merge it, and they'll put, like, more techno music. But yeah, a lot of, like, now guys here, like, what I hear from the guys are all just rap music. All rap music.
Yeah.
From Post Malone and Drake and all these people.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
Techno is not really big, but it's still heard.
Okay. Okay. Thank you, Angeles, for your help with this. This music video got suggested by one of my friends, and I thought that as a podcast it would be more interesting, because, like, music is an audio thing, so there's no too much visual I can add to it. I really hope that you enjoyed it. I really hope that you got to know something new about music, and that we can surprise you with anything from TikTok to K-pop. And I will see you or hear you in the next one.
Hope you guys enjoy. Make sure.
Yes.
Subscribe. Yeah.
Subscribe. Yeah.
Wherever you're gonna post this. But yeah, I really hope that you guys enjoyed, like, another perspective, I guess, and I hope you guys can relate to some of these, or maybe none of these, or maybe you just want to be like, oh, like, wow, that's so different to, like, what I think or my view of things. But yeah, hope you guys enjoyed, and I was super glad to be here. Thank you for having me.
Bye, everyone, and have a nice day.